What's happening, folks? Back with another reaction, back with some more Sandra. And we're going back for another single. I had access to two folders. One is singles 84 to 90, and one called the mixes 85 to 88. So we'll go through the proper singles first, then we'll go through the mixes. And the next one in the folder of the singles is Innocent Love, single version. So I presume this may vary from an album version, at least, you know, I wouldn't think you'd call it single version unless it was edited at least differently or cut differently, even if it was fundamentally the same track. So I assume this is a track that is very similar to, but perhaps not exactly like a track on one of her albums. But yeah, Innocent Love, it speaks to perhaps a naivete, meaning someone who is genuinely feeling an emotion you could call love, but perhaps without the, you know, scale or stretch of experience such that you might have a more nuanced approach. You might be maybe not cynical, but at least cautious because you're not as easily infatuated, or you're aware of all the obligations and maybe struggles and difficulties and pain that can come with relationships. So perhaps Innocent Love is being contrasted with a more wizened, if also, again, apprehensive or somewhat protective love. So yeah, it speaks to maybe young love, again, the idea of being infatuated and, you know, just letting your emotions kind of lead you, for better or for worse, I think is something which is more common early in one's emotional and romantic life. So, yeah, it makes me think about a young and perhaps a bit naive love, and, you know, which can lead to great experiences, but also great heartbreak as well. So let's find out. This is Sandra. The tune is Innocent Love, and it's a single. In a folder of singles from 84 to 90 I have access to.
I've never had my chance. feels very specific. Showing everything. It feels like maybe it's wanting to find a short-term connection, but seeing no harm in that. Yeah, I'm not quite sure exactly how to take the phrase innocent love. Didn't catch all the lines there, but it sounds less about a young, precocious, or not precocious, but naive even, loving experience. It sounds more like, hey, like, you know, let's be honest about what this is, but let's have fun with it. So, yeah, there's nothing wrong with it. So, yeah, let me know if I'm off track there, but sonically fantastic. The synth bass, the composition, some of the melodic touches. And again, I do wonder, like, I know at least some of her tunes are produced by the guy who went as Enigma, who I think was her partner for a while. But I don't know if all the tunes are produced by him, or, you know, if there were other producers even on the tracks that he worked on. So, but yeah, I enjoyed the composition and the production. And yeah, her voice is, you know, beginning to hit me a bit stronger as we start to go through more tunes. I think that's maybe only the fourth or the fifth, but I found, especially when she was really pushing it in the lead-in to the chorus, yeah, that was really hitting me. So, loving her voice, loving the danceable 80s vibes on that one. So, yeah, cool tune. Let me know what you think. I will see you next time. Peace.